Welcome to the Angular Pivot Table tutorial. This Syncfusion Angular Pivot Table is a powerful tool for organizing, summarizing, and visualizing business datasets in a cross-tabular format. In this video, I will show you how to add the Angular Pivot Table component to an Angular app. I will also show you how to configure a few of the Pivot Table's basic features like data binding and adding rows, columns, and values. I will also show you how to use formatting, filtering, field list, and grouping bar. Let me start the Angular application creation process by using the Angular CLI tool. Make sure you have installed the latest version of Node.js. First, open Visual Studio Code and install the Angular CLI using the npm install -g at angular/cli command. Next, I will create a new Angular project using the ng new project name command and name the project example. I am going to create a project with a CSS option to add a CSS style sheet, so I choose CSS option. The project creation has started, and this will create an Angular project along with its dependencies. Now, let me navigate to the project folder. To add the Syncfusion Angular Pivot Table, install the Syncfusion Angular Pivot View package using the npm install at syncfusion/ej2angular-pivot-view --save command. This will install the package along with its dependencies. Before using the Syncfusion component, it is mandatory to register the trial license key. I open the main TS file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key. To generate this license key, refer to the link in the description below. To start using the Syncfusion Angular Pivot Table component, I have to import the Syncfusion Angular Pivot View module first. So, I navigate to the app component TS file. Import the Pivot View module from the Syncfusion Angular Pivot View package and register it within the Imports array of the component section. Next, I open the app component HTML file and replace its default content with the EJS Pivot View tag. I also set the height to 500 pixels and width to 1300 pixels for the Pivot Table component. To add styles, I navigate to the style CSS file and add the required CSS references by importing the material theme. I also import the dependent CSS references like buttons, drop-downs, and pop-ups. I save the changes and run the application using the ng serve command. See, the pivot table component is rendered and no records are displayed. Next, I will show you how to bind data to the pivot table using the data source property. Initially, I declare a public variable named pivotData with the iDataSet type, which is automatically imported from Syncfusion Angular Pivot View package. Subsequently, I populate the pivotData variable with values corresponding to the fields sold, amount, country, products, year, and quarter. Moving on, I declare another public variable, data source settings, of type iDataOptions, which is automatically imported from Syncfusion Angular Pivot View package. I set the data source property of data source settings to the pivot data. To show the data source, I need to add three major axes, rows, columns, and values in data source settings. Pivot view rows are a collection of fields that need to be displayed in the row axis. Pivot view columns are a collection of fields that need to be displayed in the column axis. Pivot view values are a collection of fields that have aggregated numeric values. Now I will show you how to add pivot view columns to the table. I define the columns property and add two pivot view columns inside the data source settings property because I am going to add two pivot view columns. Using the name property, I assign the year field for the first column, the quarter field for the second column. Next, I am going to add pivot view rows. To do that, I define the rows property. Like the columns property, here I also add two rows for the country and products fields using the name property. Finally, I am going to add aggregated values in the pivot table. I define the values similar to how I define the columns and rows. I add values for the sold and amount fields using the name property. Here I set the caption units sold for the sold field and sold amount for the amount field. Finally, within EJ's pivot view tag, I bind the data source settings variable to the data source settings property. See, the pivot table is rendered with the defined data source. The year and quarter fields are in columns. The country and products fields are in rows. And the sold and amount fields are values with defined captions. Look at the values. The default summary type is sum for each field. To change the summary type, I can use the type property. This Syncfusion Angular Pivot Table supports a total of 22 summary types that can be set according to your requirements. If you want to know about summary types, please check the documentation link provided in the description below. For instance, if I want to find out the maximum sales amount for bikes in a year, I define the type property and set the value as max. See, the maximum sales amount is now displayed in the table. Next, I am going to show you the formatting, field list, filtering, and grouping bar features of the pivot table. The formatting feature allows you to display values in specified formats. The Syncfusion pivot table supports both standard and custom formats. To enable this feature, I need to define the format settings property. Here, I am going to set the currency format for the amount field. So, within this format settings, I define the name as amount, and the format as C0. Look, now the amount field is displayed in a currency format. Next, I will show you how to perform interactions like adding, removing, rearranging, filtering, and sorting the fields in the pivot table component. I use the show field list property to achieve all these interactions dynamically at runtime. I set the show field list property to true. To access this property, I need to import the field list service module from the Syncfusion Angular Pivot View package and register it inside the provider section. See, now this is the field list icon, and when I click on it, a dialog box opens. Here, I can do all the interactions of the pivot table. First, I sort. Then I remove the products field from the table. Look at the component now. The products field is removed. Now I add a field dynamically at runtime. It is added to the table. Next, let me show you how to filter the pivot table. I click the filter icon for the country field. A dialog box opened with a search text box and a list of items. Here I can either search for the item to be filtered in the text box or clear its selection in the list. I uncheck Germany in the list, and looking back at the pivot table, Germany is now removed from the country field. Next, I will show you how to enable the grouping bar in the pivot table component. The grouping bar automatically populates fields from the data source and displays them as bars. It allows us to drag data source fields between different axes and provides options to sort, filter, and remove the axes dynamically in runtime. To enable the grouping bar feature in the pivot table, I set the show grouping bar property to true. To access this, I need to import the grouping bar service module from the Syncfusion Angular Pivot View package and register it inside the providers section. Now the component is rendered with grouping bars that display the data source fields. Using these bars, I can perform interactions like sorting, filtering, removing, dragging, and dropping fields between axes. I can also change the summary type of the value fields here. In addition to rows, columns, and value axes, there's a filter axis. Fields can be added to it through code or by dragging and dropping. This axis filters the row, column, and value fields in the pivot table, as well as records not bound to the pivot table data source. For instance, I would like to display only the country field in the rows, but I want to filter the records based on the products field. In this case, I can remove the products field from the rows property and add it to the filters property. Look at the pivot table now. The products field is removed from rows and added to the filter axis. Now I can filter the records based on the products field even though it is not bound to the table. I click the filter icon, clear mountain bikes and road bikes from the list, and click OK. Looking at the pivot table now, the units and amount fields have only the values of touring bikes. In this video, I have shown you how to add the Syncfusion Angular Pivot Table component to an Angular application. I also showed you how to configure a few of its basic features like data binding and adding rows, columns, and values. I also showed you how formatting, field lists, filtering, and grouping bars work. If you want to try out the example used in this video, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also shared a link in the description where you can learn about obtaining a free license key to use our Angular suite through our community license if you are eligible. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please like and subscribe to our channel.